A very warm welcome everyone to Must Know Topics. So as you all know that in this particular series I'll be taking down various lecture rate and GD topics which will be helpful in various service selection board interviews, AFSBs and NSBs, and apart from that also in various government competitive examination. So the topic for today which will be India-Nepal relations. So this is going to be the third lecture in the series. I'll be covering this particular topic in four divisions. First would be introduction, then the Indo-Nepal Treaty 1950, the current scenario, and the conclusion part, which will include importance of maintaining friendly relations. Well, India shares around 1,850 kilometer border with Nepal, covering five states, that is Uttarakhand, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, West Bengal, and Sikkim. So this is an article published in International Journal of Scientific and Research Publication on the 1950 Treaty of Peace and Friendship. So as per under this treaty, Nepali citizens have enjoyed the benefit of availing the facilities and opportunities at par with Indian citizens. And this is the bedrock of a special relation with Nepal. Nepal has also assured at various levels that it would not allow its territory to be used for any activity against India. Well, covering the current scenarios, we can see that the former Prime Minister of Nepal, Mr. Sushil Koirala, was invited to India on oath-taking ceremony of Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi ji in the year 2013. Apart from that, there are various scholarship schemes which has been granted by India, which includes Compact Scholarship Scheme, Ayush Scholarship Scheme, APS Scholarship Scheme, General Scholarship Scheme, SARC Scholarship Scheme, Silver Jubilee Scholarship Scheme, Dr. Omi J. Baba Scholarship Scheme, Nepal and Funding Scholarship Scheme, Mahatma Gandhi Scholarship Scheme, Golden Jubilee Scholarship Scheme, and many more. So this is a picture of 18th SAARC Summit which was conducted in Kathmandu. SAARC stands for South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation. The Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi visited Kathmandu in the year 2014 for the 18th SAARC Summit. Well, apart from that, India has also given 65 million rupees to Nepal for buying iodized salt and selling it to rural. And this is another move to increase the cooperation between Nepal and India is the Nepal Television and Doordarshan. So apart from that, there has been different memorandum of understanding which was signed in the 18th SAARC summit between India and Nepal, which included the Hydel Power Plant Pact, Railway Lines and Motor Vehicles Agreement. And this is a news article which can be seen. This is of 2014, where India gave rupees 35.7 million aid for schools and hospitals in Nepal. Apart from that, India and Nepal conducts military exercise. Last year we had Surya Kiran 14 that was conducted, and this was the 14th edition of bilateral annual military exercise, and this was conducted at Nepal Army Battle School, which is in Salijhandi, Rupindehi district of Nepal. So this is one more picture of cooperation. This is the Nepal Army Chief General PC Tafa. He has been conferred with the honorary general rank of Indian Army by the President of India. Well, ECHS branch, yes, this is Ex-Serviceman Contributory Health Scheme. So this ECHS is a flagship welfare scheme of Government of India, which has also been launched in Nepal and Nepal-domiciled Indian Defence Pensioner and their dependents for providing various medical facilities and polyclinics. Well, there is one major dispute between India and Nepal which can be only resolved with the help of bilateral talk, which is the Kalapani land dispute. So this particular area, Kalapani, is near Pithorgarh of Uttarakhand, and this is of total area of around 35 km square. And this has been a major dispute between इंडिया एंड नेपाल। वेल अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट इन द रीजेंट एज पर द लेटेस्ट न्यूज वी कैन सी दैट इंडिया हैज़ ऑल्सो गिफ्टेड 23 टन्स ऑफ एसेंशियल मेडिसिन टू नेपाल विच ऑल्सो इंक्लूड्स द हाइड्रोक्सी क्लोरोक्वीन एंड दैट हैज़ बीन वेरी मच दैट विल बी वेरी मच हेल्पफुल टू नेपाल फॉर रिकवरिंग फ्रॉम द पैंडमिक। वेल अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट लेट मी जस्ट गो बैक टू द स्कालापानी लैंड डिस्प्यूट। Last year when the reorganization of Jammu and Kashmir happened, a new political map was launched in January 2020 on January 2nd and that also covered the Skalapani area. So the Nepal had some issues with the map which was published in the month of January and then from our end the statement which was given The statement which was given by the Indian side stated that, however, added that the boundary delineation process is still going on. Our map accurately depicts the sovereign territory of India. The new map has in no manner revised our boundary with Nepal, said Ministry of External Affairs spokesperson Ravish Kumar. So this was the official statement which was given by our spokesperson. Okay, coming to the conclusion part, it is very much important for us to maintain a healthy and friendly relation with all the neighboring countries and all the countries around the world. But it is also much more important to have a very good relation with Nepal, specifically because China has started building up roads and railways in Nepal. That is restoring the relation of Nepal and China. And moreover, in the year 2019, in the month of October, as we can see that this is the president of China, Mr. Xi Jinping, and this is the president of Nepal, Srimati Vidya Devi. Srimati Vidya Devi Bhandari. If I am not wrong, yes, Srimati Vidya Devi Bhandari. So this is a picture of October 2019 when China had visited Nepal. Well, so, and as we all know that China possesses a potent military threat to India. So, it is very much important that we maintain a healthy relation with Nepal as well as other neighboring countries. Well, I hope this would be very much useful for you to boost up your knowledge on the topic India and Nepal relation. And if you like this video, do like and subscribe the channel. Thank you.